My name is Jasmine. I am working as an assistant professor in St. Martin's Engineering College of Civil Department. Today I am going to deal about the environmental engineering. What is the meaning of engineering? First, we want to know about what is the meaning of environment. Environment is nothing but all which are surrounding us known as the environment, and this environment includes the all biotic, non-biotic substances and also degradable and non-degradable substances. And what is the meaning of environmental engineering? Environmental engineering. Environmental engineering is a branch of the engineering which concerns with the protection of the people from the adverse effect of the environment and also improving the quality of the environment. And in the next we are going to discuss about the waterborne diseases. Water is one of the components of the environment and it is the most important component of the environment, and it is that water is very essential for the human survival. Because and what is the waterborne diseases? When water contains certain harmful bacteria or certain harmful substances or disease producing substances, this causes the various diseases. The diseases which are caused by the consumption of the contaminated water are known as the waterborne diseases. The diseases which are caused by the consumption of the contaminated water are known as the waterborne diseases. Most of the diseases which are affected to the people which are waterborne in nature, these are caused due to the infectious agents. Those infectious agents are bacteria, virus, protozoa, and worms, etc. There are so many diseases which are caused by the water, The diseases which are spread through the bacterial infections. Diseases which are caused by bacterial infection one is the typhoid, then is malaria, and then one is the bacillus dysentery. These are the diseases which are caused by the bacterial infection. The next is the diseases which are caused by the viral infection. Diseases which are caused by viral infection are, one is the infectious jaundice. And the next one will be polymyalgia. These are the diseases which are caused by the viral infection. The next disease is diseases which is caused by protozoa. That is amoebic dysentery. These are the diseases which are caused by the consumption of the contaminated water. The next is protected water supply. What is the meaning of protected water supply? Protected water supply is the supply of treated water to the city or public or to the term. This, what is the need of protected water supply? Need of protected water supply. The first need of that protected water supply is supply the safe and the wholesome water to the city. The first need of water, the need of protected water supply is to supply safe and wholesome water. To supply safe and wholesome water to the city or town or to the consumer. The next need of the protected water supply is to supply the sufficient quantity of water to the consumers. And the next need is to supply the adequate quantity of water or to convenient point to supply the water at the convenient point and at the convenient timing. The next need of protected water supply is that to supply the water at the reasonable cost to the users. The next need of protected water supply is to encourage the person or household about the cleanliness of the users. These are the need of protected water supply. And the next is design safe. The complete water supply project consists costly and the heavier structures. So it includes the dam, reservoirs, water treatment plant and the water distribution network. These all are costly and the huge structures. It is not possible to replace these structures. Replace these structures. And also it is very difficult to replace that or change that the structure. Because of that, the capacity of this will increase us from period to period. Because of that, we have to design the or we have to construct these water works for the sufficient time, for the sufficient period means. Now, what is the design period means? Design and construction of the water works for some years means the number of years for which the water works are designed are known as the design period. The design period is nothing but the number of years for which the water works are designed is known as the design period. And mostly the water works are designed 20 to 30 years, and these years are fairly good period, and is considered as a fairly good period. You know, the next one is factors affecting design period. The design period is affected by the useful life of the structure, that is water works, means the useful life of the dam or reservoir or any other water works. The next one is the rate of population growth. This design period is also affected by the rate of population growth. Population growth is high, then the design period is less. Or if the rate of population growth is less, availability of the fund. If the available fund is more, that is that period also more. If the available fund is less, that is that period also less. And this disaster period also increases with the if there is a difficulties in the future expansion. If there is any difficulties in future expansion of the water curve, the disaster period also increases.
Time is constant, that is dp by dt is constant.
of increase in population is constant with respect to time. And the population after n decades is calculated by the equation Pn is equal to P naught n into x bar. Here Pn represents the population after n decades. Population after n decades. And P naught is present population. Present population. And where n is the number of decades. Number of decades. 1 decade is equal to 10 years. And x bar is the average increasing population. Average increase in population. This is about the arithmetic increase method. The next method is geometric increase method. And also that this arithmetic increase method gives the lesser value as compared to the what is that real value. The what is the whatever we determining that population of the city for the future, no, that will be less as compared to the real value of the population in the future. The next method is geometric increase method. Geometric increase method is based on the assumption that the percentage increase in population from decade to decade is constant. Okay, the percentage increase in population from decade to decade is constant, right? Is that constant? And it is given by the formula, that is the population after n decades. After n decades. That is Pn is equal to P naught R by 100 raised to n. Where R represents average percentage increasing population. Increasing population. And n is the number of decades. And P naught is the present population. Okay, this is about the geometric increase method. This is suitable for the larger cities.